All right, so today is a chest day. Today is Christmas Day, Monday the 25th. I got my Celsius here, and I'm kind of planning my workout. Now, originally, I kind of wanted to... I actually kind of want to work out at Planet Fitness or a different gym here today, just for the sake of, I just want to try it out. I just want to see what it's like. And for the machines I'm going to be doing today, I'm going to start off with Smith Machine Incline, High Incline. Bench. Then I'm gonna go into a, technically it's a decline hammer strength press that we have here at the gym. I don't know why we don't have just a regular flat or an incline. But I actually had someone mention, say, well, I mean, you could just change the seat height, put it all the way down, and then it could pretty much turn into a flat. And I was like, I've never done that before, because I've never was been, you know, put in that situation. So I might try that out today. So it's gonna be an incline Smith, then I'm gonna do the hammer strength decline, but it's not a decline. I'm gonna adjust the seat so it's all the way in the bottom, like all the way down low. So it's pretty much gonna be an incline Smith, then it's gonna be a flat press, I guess, in a way. And then I'm gonna do like incline flies, pec deck, keep it like that. I'll probably do pec deck and then incline flies. So that's how I'm gonna kind of set up today's workout. Just gonna try something different. I was gonna do a different type of workout style today, do some pre-exhaustion, just start with pec deck first and then go into the pressing, but I'll stick with the pressing first, the Smith machine, and then we'll work our way out and do some triceps. So the goal here today, man, is just to feel a good pump. That's all I want. I wanna try to prioritize that. Slow and controlled negatives. I kind of been moving my reps, honestly, a little bit faster than I normally would. You know, for the shoulder pressing, for example, when I'm doing the Smith machine, I kind of been going really fast with it. Not that that's bad, it's just I want to control it a little bit more, because I mean, through this whole bulk, I've been doing slow negatives, and that's where I've seen a lot of size, a lot of growth come from. And that's just what I'm gonna continue to do. So we're gonna do slow negatives on pretty much everything, tight squeeze. I'm gonna get in the gym before this pump formula tries to wear off. I got my Gatorade right here by my side. So yeah, I think it's gonna be the Smith machine. We'll do the flat hammer press, a pec deck, and then an incline cable fly, and then some triceps. And as far as the sets go, probably one hard set on the first two movements, and then two sets on the cables, we'll see. And then one or two sets for the triceps, probably two sets for the triceps, just to get a little bit more. But classic day today right here, overcast, a little bit of rain, couple people here at the gym, which I'm actually surprised. I see four cars here in total. Oh, actually more, five or six. Yeah, so I mean, there's quite a bit of people here. I actually kind of want it to be completely empty, because yesterday when I came here, the gym was completely empty. No one was here, all but one or two dudes, and I was just doing cardio, so it was nice. So got some commitment here, people are here, so I'm gonna go in, get you guys now.
So I got 185 on the bar right here. So goal, I want to get slow reps. I don't really care 8 to 10, I just want them nice and slow. Good. I control that more than I believe I did last workout, but that felt solid. I don't know, I might hit another set. I kind of want to. kind of want to. You know, I might add a 10 each side. Let's see what we can get here. And then I might take a set or two off of the pec deck or whatnot. I don't know if that's a smart idea. We'll see. I'm going to check my numbers and crunch the numbers on my phone and see if that makes sense, see how much weight I did last time, but that felt good though. That felt good. So, we're at 205 pounds right here on the bench. So I'm just going to try to kick out as many as I can here.
Might only be like three or four.
That felt pretty solid. Felt pretty solid. 4 reps off the bat. Trying to go nice and slow still. So now I'm gonna do the hammer press. I have a feeling that's gonna feel really good. Alright. Put this on for bracing. See how many we can get here. Nice and slow. That felt good. I'm gonna decrease the weight. Probably just do 2 plates, 25 each side here. Felt good though. I can definitely feel a squeeze right there. Gonna try to get 8 reps right here. Does feel surprisingly pretty good though, I will say. Try to get like 9 or 10 reps here. Oh.
soon, bro.
I'll see you soon.
Take care, man.
I never really feel the pump on that one. I just feel the stretch, but I can push that better. The Wiz Khalifa remix of the song is way better.
All right, so the workout. The workout was pretty solid, I gotta say. The high points of the workout, I gotta say, the Smith machine felt very good today. I was catching a pump off of that pretty early, and then the hammer strength press, man, that issue felt a heck of a lot better than I thought. I guess when I always walked by it, I always assumed it was a decline just because of the handles where they start, but then they kind of press upwards, I guess. And I set the seat all the way down low to the bottom, just because I don't really want to target the lower chest as much. I'd rather target right here and above. So I found when I set the seat all the way down to the bottom that it felt pretty good. Let me just see if my camera's still. Okay. Well, yeah, it felt great though. So, I mean, the pump was great off of that. I will say I probably did one too many sets with the Smith and the hammer. I should have done just one set with the Smith and then maybe one or two with the hammer, just because I kind of felt fatigued a bit as soon as I got to the pec deck, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. I'm still working hard, but I gotta say, I do like how that felt. That felt pretty solid. So the plan is, I'm gonna go home, grub, probably snag another Gatorade, pound that, make some rice. Unfortunately, gonna have to probably have eggs again, that and tuna, because I forgot to take out some lean ground beef, so I forgot to hit that up. So yeah, I'm gonna have to have that. But the workout went very well. The weight's at like 206. I can kind of start to tell that the abs are definitely going bye-bye, which isn't a bad thing. It's bulking. But yeah, I mean, that's bulking. You know, essentially, you're not always going to have shredded abs. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. You know, you're going to bulk. You're going to get at a bigger weight. You know, if you're not on steroids, you're not going to stay lean, especially when you're bulking. There's a lot of guys, when they say they're bulking, they're on steroids, they look like they're even more shredded than what they were on their cut. They're getting bigger and more lean. Just for a natural, it's not going to happen. But I got to say, although I do like this individual for some of the advice that he gives, and he's definitely stronger than me at some lifts, I will give him that. There is a couple things, like, for example, actually there's two. So there's Greg O'Gallagher, and then there's Alex Eubank. And these two guys, they never really go full on a bulk from what I've seen. I only ever see Greg. He'll go from like mid 170s to then the 181. So he'll go from like 175 is his cut weight, and then 181 is like his bulk weight, which is like, if you're a natural, you're not going to be gaining that much mass over time. That's just not, it's not necessarily the best idea. And I mean, there's a couple training ideas that I don't necessarily agree with him, but I think overall he gives pretty dang good advice for naturals. Progressive overload, getting stronger there. And then Alex Eubank, kind of the same thing. Both of those guys are really obsessed with staying lean, and I get it, because you're going to look great in photos. You look great overall, but if you're not bulking, you're not going to maximize your natural potential. You need to go on these bulks and cuts. Doesn't mean you're going to get big and fat. I think Alpha Destiny, or Alex Leonidas, is a prime example of this. I think he's evolved over the years. He would cut down and he'd bulk up. And sometimes his cuts and his bulks vary from like 30 pounds. You know, that's the difference right there. And look at the progress he's made throughout all the years versus a Greg O'Gallagher or versus an Alex Eubank. But Alex is pretty young already. So, and I mean, the progress that Alex is making, Alex Leonidas, or Bald Omni Man, I forgot his name, the progress that they make when they bulk up and they cut down, that's kind of what you guys want to do. You don't want to just necessarily say, oh, I'm going to cut 5 pounds and then, all right, I'm going to bulk up 5 pounds. You're not going to make any big jumps in progress, and that's not necessarily the way to go, I think, in my opinion. Especially if you're natural, you need to really actually go on a legit bulk for several months on end, not just for 3 months in the stop and cut and 3 months in stop and cut. Like, my recommendation when you're bulking, when you're lean bulking, is take it slow, be in a 300 calorie surplus, something more around there, and then, hold on, let me get my arm a rest, and then maintain that for, I legit would say, if you just started lifting and you're skinny, guys, you really should be bulking for like the first couple years of your career. But if you're in my position now where you've definitely got some size, I mean, I'm gonna be lean bulking in total for another, once I cut weight, it's gonna be like a year and a half of the whole duration of my bulk. I'm not saying I'm a bulk for a whole another year and a half. I'm saying it is going to be, the whole total time spent bulking is about a year and a half. And it's a slow process of just adding about a pound per, I would say it's like a half a pound per week. So, you know, we're rocking somewhere around 2 pounds per month. So two pounds per month is 24 pounds, essentially, and maybe a little bit more than that. And I would say that's probably a good way to work from, because now your hormones are optimized. You feel good. Energy's good. Sex drive's there. Strength's going up, muscle mass is increasing, and you're giving yourself enough time to bulk back up. Because as you guys probably know, it's like you bulk up, you cut down, you bulk up, cut down, you're still rising after all these years. You don't want to like bulk up, cut, and you're not really making any big jumps in progress physically. Now, you know, everyone has their own methods. That's my method. I strongly feel that people should be doing that. You know, this isn't an excuse just to get fat, but you're not going to keep your abs totally shredded, lean out of your mind unless you're using gear or unless you're just not packing out a lot of size and you just want to stay lean, you know. But my method is bulk up, cut down when it's really needed. But really, most of your lifting career, you should be in a surplus or at least maintaining. So I'm going to go home right now, pound some food. If you guys are interested, go on to my Whitaker Strength website for my program or for online coaching. There, you're going to see the whole program layout, everything exactly what I do. And every single workout that I do is stuff that I've already written in the Berserker program. So if you guys want to follow along, go ahead and follow along. So I'm going to catch you guys next video. Peace.